Today, we dive deep into the world of Charlie Chaplin, a renowned film figure celebrated not just for his memorable silent performances, but also for his thought-provoking quotes. Chaplin, whose primary medium was silent film, expressed profound thoughts through his written and spoken words. As English learners, this presents a fantastic opportunity for us to explore intricate facets of the language. Are you eager to delve into the linguistic beauty of his statements? Join us on this enlightening journey.
You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.
This quote uses the future modal, will, in you'll, which is a contraction of you will. It emphasizes the power of a positive outlook. Here, the adverb just modifies the verb smile. Chaplin suggests that even in difficult times, a simple act like smiling can make life feel meaningful and worth living.
The mirror is my best friend because when I cry, it never laughs.
This sentence employs the present simple tense in is and laughs. The conjunction because introduces a reason for the preceding statement. The pronoun it refers to mirror. Chaplin utilizes personification, giving the mirror human-like qualities to emphasize its consistent and unchanging reflection.
Life is a beautiful, magnificent thing, even to a jellyfish.
This quote uses the indefinite articles a before beautiful, magnificent thing and jellyfish. The conjunction even is used for emphasis, suggesting the universality of life's beauty. The preposition to shows relation. Chaplin implies that the marvel of life is evident to every living being, irrespective of its complexity.
Nothing is permanent in this wicked world, not even our troubles.
The verb is, in the present simple tense, indicates a general truth about the world. The adjective wicked describes the noun world, implying its unpredictable and challenging nature. The conjunctions not even are used for emphasis, suggesting that even the most distressing experiences are transient.
To truly laugh, you must be able to take your pain and play with it.
The verb laugh is in the base form, expressing a general idea. The modal must indicates necessity. The preposition with in play with it conveys the idea of interaction or engagement. Chaplin emphasizes the resilience and strength in finding humor, even in one's struggles.
A day without laughter is a day wasted.
The preposition, without, indicates the absence of something, in this case, laughter. The verb is in the present simple tense signifies a general truth or principle. Chaplin's sentiment here is that laughter and joy are essential components of a fulfilling life, and without them, life loses its value.
Your naked body should only belong to those who fall in love with your naked soul.
The modal should suggests a piece of advice or a norm. The verb belong denotes possession or affiliation. Chaplin emphasizes the significance of genuine connection and love that goes beyond the superficial.
We think too much and feel too little. More than machinery, we need humanity.
The verbs think and feel contrast cognitive and emotional experiences. The comparative structure, more than we need, suggests that while technology is valuable, human connection is paramount. Chaplin critiques a world focused on progress at the expense of empathy.
My pain may be the reason for somebody's laugh, but my laugh must never be the reason for somebody's pain.
The modal may conveys possibility, while must denotes an obligation. Chaplin's message here is about ensuring our happiness doesn't come at the expense of another's suffering.
Words are cheap. The biggest thing you can say is elephant.
The adjective cheap describes the noun words, suggesting their lack of value when not used sincerely. The humorous comparison with elephant underlines that big words or statements might not always carry deep meanings. Chaplin highlights the distinction between verbosity and substance.
Despair is a narcotic. It lulls the mind into indifference.
The verb lulls denotes a gentle but compelling influence, suggesting how despair can numb one's senses. By comparing despair to a narcotic, Chaplin portrays its powerful and potentially harmful effects on the human psyche
After all, there are more valid facts and details in works of art than there are in history books.
The comparative phrase, more than, stresses the richness of art compared to formal records. Chaplin insinuates that art, in its subjective beauty, can often reveal more truth than objective history.
We must laugh in the face of our helplessness against the forces of nature, or go insane.
The modal verb must suggest a necessity. The conjunction or presents an alternative. Through this, Chaplin expresses the importance of resilience and finding humor, even when faced with insurmountable odds.
I remain just one thing and one thing only, and that is a clown.
The pronoun that and conjunction and give structure to his self-definition. By focusing on being just one thing, Chaplin emphasizes his commitment to his identity as a performer, despite the multifaceted nature of his career.
Life is a play that does not allow testing.
The negative does not denotes restriction. Chaplin likens life to a performance without rehearsals, conveying that we must navigate its challenges in real time without prior preparation.
I'd sooner be called a successful crook than a destitute monarch.
The adverb sooner indicates preference. Here, Chaplin expresses that he'd rather be perceived in a negative light with success than bear a noble title without means or respect.
The saddest thing I can imagine is to get used to luxury.
The modal can indicates ability. Chaplin conveys the idea that becoming complacent or overly accustomed to luxury can lead to a lack of appreciation for life's simpler joys.
Simplicity is a difficult thing to achieve.
The adjective difficult describes the challenge of attaining simplicity. Chaplin underscores that genuine simplicity is a virtue, not easily attained in a complex world.
Why should poetry have to make sense?
The modal should and verb phrase have to convey societal expectations. Chaplin challenges the notion that art, specifically poetry, needs to be logical or easily understood, emphasizing its subjective nature. Well done, learners. Together, we've navigated the depths of Charlie Chaplin's reflections, highlighting key grammatical components like verb tenses, modal verbs, adjectives, and more. As you continue your English learning journey, consider revisiting Chaplin's quotes and films. See if you can spot more linguistic elements and nuances. Remember, every piece of content, be it a film, speech, or written text, is a treasure trove of learning opportunities. Stay curious and keep exploring.
Visit our site, EnglishSpeechChannel.com, for exclusive access to video transcripts, offline audio, English lessons, and private classes. Don't forget to explore our free and new ebooks. Also, subscribe to our weekly newsletter for the latest updates. Links in the description below. Thanks for your support.